everyone, welcome to the channel. Today, thanks to Arjun, I'll be presenting my Verilog project, PWM Shift Register. Now, before I move forward, I would just quickly like to mention out that 99% of you have still not subscribed to the channel. So if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. It motivates us a lot to keep making these videos. Thank you. So let's get started. So PWM Shift Register. Now, this will be our trajectory for the presentation, that first we'll discuss what is exactly PWM and shift registers. Then we'll discuss how we have implemented them in Verilog HDL, and then we'll discuss that why, what was the need to make this project and why did we use this topic on our Verilog project idea apart from scoring good grades. That was one other reason. So moving forward, first, what is PWM? PWM stands for pulse width modulation. To understand this in a more easier terms, I'll take the use case of an LED. Say you want to give this LED a fading signal. You want the LED to be bright at some point of time and you want it to be dim at some point of time. So the most obvious solution that comes to your mind is to connect it to an analog signal where you vary the voltage or the current. But from a hardware designer or an embedded system engineer's point of view, you know that constructing a DAC or implementing a digital to analog converter in your hardware is not only complicated but also very expensive solution. So instead of having an analog signal, we use this technique called pulse width modulation. And what we are doing is that essentially instead of sending a pure analog signal, we send a pure digital signal, which is varying at a very high frequency. So here, for an example, you want to glow this LED at 50% of its brightness. So you send a signal with 50% duty cycle. Duty cycle, that stands for the ratio between the on time and the off time of your pulse. So here you can see that your pulse is on for half of the duration and off for half of the time period. So that gives us a 50% brightness. If you want to decrease the brightness, you decrease the duty cycle, let's say to 20%. If you want to increase the brightness, you increase the duty cycle, let's say to 85%. So that is how PWM signal works. Now you can implement this PWM signal generation in Verilog HDL by this complicated piece of code that is in front of your screens. Yep, that's it. You simply have to initialize a counter that counts from 0 to 100, continuously check that counter with respect to a particular value. And if the counter goes above that value, you set it to 0. When it's below that particular value, that is your duty cycle, it remains as 1. That is all we have to do. But here, if we want 8 different PWM outputs, we'll have to use 8 different counters and 8 different sign statements. That would make the hardware much more complex. This is where shift registers come in. So let's have a look right now at the shift register part of it. On the right hand side, you have the code. On the left hand side, we'll be explaining the working of this 8-bit shift register. Let's say you want to put in data serially into the shift register. So when you want to put in 1, you have the serial input D in as set to 1 and you give a clock pulse to the shift register. Now, as soon as this clock pulse hits the shift register, this 1 gets shifted inside. When you give another clock pulse, another 1 gets shifted inside. So you want to shift in a 0 to the shift register, you set D into 0 and then you give another clock pulse. So a 0 gets shifted right. Now all this shifting is waste because this shift register is not connected to the output. What we have connected to the output is another register called the latch register. And this register is controlled by this latch signal. All that happens is that as soon as this latch signal hits our register, the contents of our main shift register get copied to the latch register. This is what happens in the last few lines of the code. You can see D output gets assigned the value of D, that is the latching process that is taking place. So now we have understood the concepts of PWM and the concepts of shift register. Now let's combine both of them. So initially we discussed that we have a counter that continuously counts. And we have a shift register. Here we have the Verilog code for the counter. We initialize it to take the clock pulse input and continuously count from 0 to 100 and come back to 0. That is our counter. Now here we initialize 8 duty cycle values because we want 8 different PWM signals on our output using just one counter. So we have initialized this one counter. We have 8 different duty cycle values. Now comes the most important part, that is the integration, and this is where the magic happens. So what we do is that we know that this counter is continuously counting from 0 to 100. While it's counting, we cycle through each duty value one by one and compare it with the value of the counter. If the value of the counter is less than the duty cycle value, then we want to send a data output 1. We send it using the serial in input of the shift register. And if this counter value is greater than the duty cycle value, then we send a serial in output as 0. This serial in value goes to our shift register and on the next clock pulse gets shifted to the shift register. So we cycle through all these duty cycle values and accordingly shift values onto the shift register. And after the 8th value, we simply send a pulse onto the latch signal so that we can latch all these 8 values that we just shifted. So if you have a look at the output of the simulation, you can see that you have an output register PWM720. This 8-bit output has PWM signals on every bit. If you have a look at each bit individually, you will see a PWM signal of a different duty cycle. Say on PWM7, you have a PWM signal of an 85% duty cycle. And on PWM6, you have a signal of 10% duty cycle, 20%, 30% and so on. And the only input required for the whole module was the clock input that we gave. Now, the question of the hour, why? Why did we make this project and why should you go for this project? So the first reason is that when you talk about Verilog, it is very similar to embedded C and C. So this same code can be ported onto C and you can use that for a microcontroller to control 8 different PWM outputs using a shift register with just one single timer or one single counter channel. Because you know in controllers and in processors, we have limited hardware. Unlike in Verilog and FPGA boards where we are designing our own hardware. So when it is a hardware intensive role, you can use the same code. The next reason is that the area versus speed trade-off. Understanding that is one of the reasons why we made this project. So if you think about it, you could have simply made 8 different counters and made 8 different assign statements. Assign statement is implemented on hardware by using a comparator. So on the hardware, you would have made 8 different comparators, 8 different counters, and the circuit would have become very complicated. The area would have increased, although it would have been very fast. What our implementation does is that we do a trade-off with speed and area. We have a smaller area, but we compromise a little on the speed because the PWM output that we are getting and the PWM output that we were getting previously, both of them are still imperceptible to the human eye. So here, we can trade off the area. The third reason is that to understand the serial multiplexing of data. When you think about it, the screen that you're watching this video right now or the screen on which I'm recording this video right now, these screens have thousands and millions of pixels. So each pixel cannot be connected parallelly to our controller or processor. That would be stupid. So everywhere we are using serial multiplexing of data. And this project was an attempt to understand how complex data can be multiplexed easily. One more reason why I personally chose this project is that when your deadline for project submission is 12 hours away and PWM and shift registers are the only two things that you have ever worked upon in your life, combining them and making a substantial project is the only option that you have. So that is what I did. I hope that's not what you are doing and try understanding this project. And if you like the video, do like, share, subscribe. It takes a lot of effort for us and Arjun to make these videos. And if you are a digital electronics or hardware design enthusiast, trust me, Arjun is doing some amazing work. The videos on this channel will keep you engrossed. And even if you aren't, if you're watching this video just for the sake of it or just to complete your project one night ago, please consider subscribing as a thank you or as a gesture of your gratitude. Thank you and see you guys soon. Once again, like, share, subscribe.